two, three.
When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that will be. When we all see Jesus, we'll sing and shout the victory. Shall all pass away, no more tears. One day you'll make sense of it all, Jesus. One day every question resolved, every anxious thought left behind.
Welcome to Music and Message. Are you grieving the loss of a loved one? We lost many friends and loved ones during this pandemic. It's been heartbreaking for many of us. And we ask ourselves this question, does God even understand the pain we are going through? In fact, Jesus too was filled with grief when his dear friend Lazarus passed away. Many of us who went to Sunday school know the shortest verse in the Bible, Jesus wept. Thank God we have a Savior who knows exactly how we feel. But a little earlier in the chapter, we see something very, very strange. Jesus, knowing that Lazarus has died, tells his disciples, Lazarus is dead, and for your sake I am glad. When everyone is sad, Jesus is glad. Is this the same Jesus that wept? Why was Jesus glad? He knew something that the disciples didn't. He knew what lay beyond the bend. When our children took their first train journey from my hometown Tiruvalla to Bangalore, they were excited about the journey. Immediately after you leave Tiruvalla and approach Kottayam, there are twin tunnels that the train needs to go through. It being their first train journey, as soon as we entered the tunnel, we were plunged into pitch darkness and I felt four hands clutching onto my leg. Though dark, I could see the fear on their faces. They weren't sure what happened. It was as if they lost their eyesight all of a sudden. If you could see my face, you would see a big broad smile. While the children were frightened, their father was smiling. Not because I didn't understand their situation, but because I knew light would burst forth in about 10 seconds as we crossed the tunnel. Sometimes when we go through the dark tunnels of our lives, we may be all worked up, but our Heavenly Father is smiling because He knows what lies ahead. Death is a dark tunnel, but we need to understand that our Lord conquered death and hates. He went through that door and now has left it wide open, so that we may enter into those gates with shouts as we proclaim, "Where, O death, is thy sting? O grave, where is your victory?" We all need to face death one day. That's the sad reality. But that day will be a glorious day. Absent with the body, present with the Lord. Billy Graham once said, "One day you will hear that Billy Graham is dead. Don't you believe a word. I will be more alive than ever. I would have just changed my address." For a believer of the Lord Jesus, death is just an address change, a change for the better. Are you worried about tomorrow? Jesus said, "Don't worry about tomorrow." There are just two important days for us, this day and that day. Today is the day of salvation. Today, if you hear His voice, do not harden your hearts. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice. Make the best of today and look forward to that day when the perishable has been clothed with the imperishable and the mortal with immortality. One day we will see Him face to face, and the Bible says that we shall be just like Jesus. What a glorious day that will be. There will be no more cancer, no more COVID, no more fear, and no more pain. One day, one day.